Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making French hot chocolate. And I've already started over here. I have my double boiler going. And I turned it down a little bit. But you can see that there is melted chocolate in the bottom, almost all the way melted. It is 2 1/2 squares of baking chocolate. It's unsweetened, and they just come in squares, so take 2 1/2 of them. And once you have it melted over a double boiler, on the top of a double boiler, you may add 1/2 cup of water and continue to stir. Add 3/4 cup of sugar. This is 1/2 cup and this is 1/4. So all together, 3/4 cup of sugar, continuing to stir. And you need a pinch of salt. So I'm just going to shake a little bit of salt in from the salt shaker. Just regular salt. Now what we do is turn this up a little bit so it gets plenty of heat and it has cooled down a little bit from those additions. We want this to boil 4 minutes. So I'm going to bring it to a boil and boil it for 4 minutes. And this is called the base of the French hot chocolate. We need to cool it off once it has boiled 4 minutes. And after it's cool, it may be stored in the refrigerator for several days. So you can use on it for several days after you get it made. But I'll go ahead and get it cooled and show you how we finish it up. Here is our chocolate base, and I'm ready to take it off the stove. It's in a double boiler, so it can't really bubble a lot, but as long as you have it right there at the boiling point and stir for about 4 minutes, then you'll be fine with this base. So it's going to come off the stove, and I would like to point out, I didn't mention earlier, on the 2 1/2 squares, they are 1 ounce squares. So that's 2 1/2 ounces of unsweetened chocolate that went in here. So here's our base. We need to cool it off, and then we'll continue with our recipe. Now here is the base of our French hot chocolate. And I let it cool at room temperature, and then I put it in the refrigerator so it's nice and chilled. And what I've done in the meantime is to beat some whipping cream. And this was 1/2 pint, which is the same as 1 cup before it was whipped. So I just used an electric mixer and got it to this point where it's nice and sturdy. We're going to put these together and fold in the whipping cream. So I've poured the base in with the whipped cream, and I just want to fold it around so it's completely mixed, but I have to do this gently because I don't want to deflate the whipped cream. And then this is something that you can use immediately, or you can put it in your refrigerator and use on it as you choose. Now I'm going to make a serving for you. Just take a little glass like this, or a cup, whatever you like to serve hot chocolate in. And then you need about 2 tablespoons, this is a 2 tablespoon measure, of your mixture of chocolate base and whipped cream. And just put that down on the bottom. That's about it. And I'll just stick that in there for the time being. Over here I have scalded milk, and it's very hot. But it's not boiling. You don't want to boil milk when you're scalding it. I do have a quick tip on scalding milk in case you need to look at that before you do this. But once you have your scalded milk, this is 6 cups here to do what I have, although you can just heat as much milk as you want to use and then worry about the rest later. But we're going to pour that over the top, and the easiest thing for me to do is ladle it. So that may be a little messy, but we'll try that. And what happens is your base and whipped cream will float up to the top and give a nice finish, and that's why it's called French hot chocolate. So it looks like that. And then you can even dress it up a little bit if you want to. So I'm going to show you on top of that foam that we have. We can put a little extra. This is just ready whip. If you want to save out some of the whipped cream or do twice as much whipped cream, you can use whipped cream. But I'm going to put this on the top. And then I have this old beat up tea strainer, and I'll tell you why it's beat up. Carter has used it as a toy over the years, my grandson Carter. But I put just cocoa in there, and it's kind of the best thing I have to be able to sieve a little bit of cocoa onto the top and make it look really pretty. So this is our French hot chocolate, and I would suggest that you serve it with something we made recently, biscotti. So I'll have to go down the side to get to it, but I've got it. And there, it's gone into the hot chocolate. Let's taste it. Mmm, really good. The two together, perfect treat at Christmas time.